Hi everyone, I'm Jessan Cherian, and I'm one of the software engineers working at Microsoft on Azure AD Connect Cloud Sync. In this video, I will be going over how to install and configure the Azure AD Connect Cloud Sync agent on a Windows server. Before we get started on that, I would like to give a brief overview of the agent and its prerequisites. So why move to Cloud Sync? There are many benefits in moving to Cloud Sync from Azure AD Connect. Cloud Sync is much easier to set up with lightweight agents instead of the heavy on-premises footprint that Azure AD Connect leaves behind. Deployment of Cloud Sync is very quick and easy, as you will see in the demo shortly, and the configuration can be easily managed from Azure AD Portal, which is not offered by Azure AD Connect. By using Cloud Sync and the lightweight agent infrastructure, there is no longer a need to deploy a robust server in your data center to run the service. And unlike Azure AD Connect that requires a SQL Server to support large directories, there is no need for that with Cloud Sync. So you could potentially save money on SQL Server licensing as well. Moving on to resiliency, multiple agents can be deployed in your environment to accomplish high availability. On the other hand, Azure AD Connect uses active and staging mode to achieve some resiliency, but it does not match what Cloud Sync offers. Regarding performance, Azure AD Connect only supports sequential syncs, whereas Cloud Sync can have parallel sync when dealing with multiple sources. Finally, Cloud Sync supports synchronizing to an Azure AD tenant from a multi-forest disconnected AD environment. This includes mergers and acquisitions, where the acquired company's AD forests are isolated from the parent company's AD forests. There are a couple of prerequisites before we jump into the installation of the agent. You will need a domain or enterprise administrator credentials to set up an agent in your environment. These credentials will be used to create and configure the Group Managed Service Account, or GMSA, which is used to run the Cloud Sync service. We will get more into GMSA on the next slide. You also need to be a hybrid identity or global administrator to manage the Cloud Sync configuration in the Azure portal. The server on which Cloud Sync agent is installed should be running Windows Server 2016 or greater, with a minimum of 4 GB of RAM and .NET runtime version of 4.7.1 or higher. These servers should be treated as a tier 0 server based on the Active Directory administrative tier model. Also, any on-premises firewall configuration needed to enable the agent to communicate with Azure Active Directory. More instructions can be found by following the link on the screen. As mentioned earlier, Cloud Sync agent will be running under a Group Managed Service Account, or GMSA. A Group Managed Service Account is like a Managed Service Account, or MSA, but the key difference is that GMSA can be used across multiple servers, while MSA is bound to a single machine. In our case, multiple lightweight agents in the same domain can use the same GMSA as a service account, which reduces overhead and is very secure when compared to normal user accounts, as the password is managed by the OS itself. By default, the installation will require you to enter a domain or enterprise administrator account to create the GMSA. We will go over this in the demo. To support GMSA, there are new prerequisites needed. The Active Directory schema in the installing domain's forest needs to be updated to Windows Server 2012 or greater to create a GMSA. At least one domain controller in the domain must be running Windows Server 2012 or higher. If not, the creation of GMSA will fail. PowerShell Remote Server Administrative Tools, or RSAT modules, are installed by default on domain controllers. If they were somehow removed, please ensure that all domain controllers in the domain in which the GMSA is created have PowerShell RSAT modules installed. The server where the agent is being installed must be domain joined and has to be running Windows 2016 or greater, as mentioned in the earlier slide. The new requirement is that the server must be domain joined to use GMSA. Now that we have gone over the overview and the requirements of Cloud Sync, let us jump into the demo. First, let us go over how to download the Cloud Sync agent. Head over to Azure Portal and log in with your hybrid identity or global administrator credentials. Navigate to Azure Active Directory. Note that you must be a hybrid identity or global administrator to manage the Cloud Sync configuration. As you can see, I'm logged in as a hybrid identity administrator. Head over to Azure AD Connect and click Manage Azure AD Cloud Sync. You can download the agent by clicking Download Agent here and accepting the terms and download. Once the executable is downloaded, double-click to run it. Please read and accept the license terms and the privacy notice and click install for the wizard to be installed. Once the setup is completed, you can close the installer. You will be greeted with a welcome page. Read and click next to move on to the next page. In this page, you will enter your Azure AD hybrid identity or global administrator credentials to connect to Azure Active Directory. Once you sign in, you'll automatically be moved to the next page. In this page, you will configure the group managed service account, which will be used to run the Cloudsync service. You have two options, create GMSA or use custom GMSA. The recommended way is to go with option one, where you have the wizard create the service account for you. If the service account already exists, that is, if another agent is already installed on this domain, then going with option one will reuse that account on the server. No new GMSA will be created. The default GMSA name is in the format domain/prof agent GMSA. So in my case, it will be mufflinopolis/prof agent GMSA. You also have the flexibility to enter your own custom GMSA that you have created. If you go with this option, make sure that the custom GMSA has permission to read certain properties on Active Directory. You can find the full list of required permissions by following the link on the screen. I'm going to go forward with option one. Since I'm asking the wizard to create a brand new GMSA for me, I will have to enter the domain or enterprise administrator credentials. Once entered, click Next to move on to the next page. On this page, you will be able to connect your Active Directory domains you wish to synchronize to the cloud. You will notice that my current domain is automatically added as one of the configured domains because I had previously entered it on the Configure Service Account page. If you have multiple domains in your forest, these will be discovered automatically and are available in the drop-down list here. Since I only have one domain in this forest, I will remove the current domain and add it again for the demo purpose. This will bring up a dialog box asking to enter the domain administrator of the added domain. Note that you will also be able to enter enterprise admin credentials here. The credentials entered here will be used to set certain permissions to the GMSA on the configured domain. This is needed so that the service can communicate with the domain and read data from the domain. The credentials are not stored by the agent. If you have a preference on which domain controller the service should talk to first, then you can click Select Domain Controller Priority. Since I only have one domain controller, there is no point setting this. The agent will contact the domain controllers according to the order in which it is entered. You can move the ordering by clicking the arrows here. Click OK to close the dialog box. You will notice that the domain was successfully added as one of the configured domains. Click Next if you're satisfied with your configured domains. This page will give you a high-level overview of how the wizard will configure the Cloudsync agent. The username here represents the account that is used by the agent to communicate with the domain. Please review the configuration and click Confirm and wait for the configuration to complete. This process can take 2 to 3 minutes to complete. While we wait, let us go over what is happening during this configuration. A group managed service account or GMSA is created in this domain. The agent is being registered with Hybrid Identity Service or HIS, which manages the communication pipeline between the on-premises agent and the cloud. A new resource group is created with the current domain name, and the agent is added to the resource group. If there are other agents installed in this domain, they will be in the same resource group. The domain will also be exposed in Azure Portal for your Cloudsync configuration. Once the installation and the configuration are complete, head over to Azure Portal to complete all your provisioning configurations. Thanks for watching, and make sure to check out the links below to learn more about Azure AD Connect Cloudsync. Thank you.